Speaks around that money.
So the convention is technically over. We're back from the barbecue, and it has been an amazing convention. And personally, it is an amazing convention because I can see a lot of things that the New Jersey team has built on from the DC convention. It has been, to me, it's been like top notch. But to you, what do you think, you know, from the day you came in and now that everything is done, what are your impressions?
Actually, this is my first time I've attended the BFU, and I won't be able to tell what happened and what is happening. So, comparatively, I won't be the best person to say anything about that. However, I think it was amazing. The organization, everything was done perfectly from my own side of it. If I have to mention any area of improvement, I might talk about the gala, because there was so much focus on the fundraising for what we don't know.
So let me just interject a little bit.
Sure.
You have to understand that BFU were trying to raise funds, right?
Funds for what?
Well, funds to run the organization, because just to let you know, just by having the convention, most in the past, they've been running negative after most conventions. So they're trying to anticipate and make sure that they don't run, they're not negative. That's what my impression is, right? So the fundraising part of it is important because they want to raise funds. They want to be financially stable. And then also the charitable works that they're doing all around Cameroon or Bui, also, that's where the funds come from. So that's why you see them, the focus is on, the focus is really huge. But yes, also what I'll say in support of what you are saying, right, is they could have like a specific amount of time, because I'll tell you something, you agree with me. When you're going to the airport, are you late?
Of course, I have enough time ahead.
Okay, so if they say the plane is taking off at 10, it's taking off at 10.
Yeah.
So I would say they could say specifically, they'll start the event, let's say at 8, 10 to midnight is fundraising, right? Everybody knows that. After that time, they go on to something else.
It's
you agree with me?
It's a little tricky too. It's a little tricky. I'll tell you why, because from our background and how we behave and react, when you say fundraising is between 7 and 10, I bet you 80% of the people won't come for that fundraising because they think they have to come achieving something and they don't want to spend. And some others will come, don't get me wrong. But most of them will be like, okay, we'll come after the fundraiser or the time slot for the fundraiser so that you can come catch fun. It's a gala.
Yeah.
Most people look at gala to come dance and have fun, to chat, not to come and they're thinking of some fundraising thing, right? So,
but
yeah.
That is not really typical just of Bui, but I think they're trying to raise funds, and your point that you're making is valid. And I think when this video goes out, they'll take that into consideration. Another thing too, what do you think about the youths, their involvement in, the running or the management, and then
amazing.
The cultural part of it too?
It's amazing. If I was told without witnessing that you could see kids involved in such a convention like this, I would have said no. But their participation and everything is really, it's great. It's great, and I applaud it, and I wish they keep on that tradition of getting the kids involved and do so many things.
So did you make it to New York? How was the trip?
It's interesting.
What is interesting about it?
Just being with the people, farmers.
Was it the first time going to New York?
Yeah, it was my first time, but it wasn't really much about seeing the place at the end of the day. At first, it was going to see New York, but because I couldn't make it to see everywhere I wanted to see, it wasn't anymore. But New York, we left late, we got there, we didn't have the opportunity to see all the places. So it was more of like the interaction with the people, not really much.
Okay, cultural part. Did you attend the cultural night?
I did.
Okay, what was like your... the point, you know, where you're like, oh, this is amazing, I love this. What did you see there that you...
For someone like myself who loves some tradition, especially the dancer tradition, the performances, the involvement and everything, everybody getting carried away with everything that was going on, it's amazing. It just gives me the sense of belonging.
I like that. And I'll tell you, what about the artists?
The artists?
Yeah. Did you see him? Did you see him perform?
Which one of them? There were two artists.
I mean, I'm talking about Sheyov.
Oh, Sheyov. Oh, of course, we have Sheyov. He's entertaining and he does his best at what he does. So okay. It was good.
Great. So, yeah, so your input is, I think, is really important. And a lot of people, you know, would look at this. Now, the great thing about it is your first time, and your impressions are just amazing, spot on. And I'm sure you're going to be in Dallas, you know.
Aside from the weather, which I hope will be great at that time, because I hear it's really hot.
Yeah.
I haven't been there before, never been there. That will be my first time I have to come. Let's see how it goes. I can't promise anything.
Okay, sounds good. But I'm sure that they're going to build on this. And every year it just gets better.
I know, right?
Yeah.
I learned last year was a little crazy, and when I see what has happened from what I heard, it's like day and night, which is really awesome.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, thank you very much. And it's been interesting getting the convention from a first-timer and also from your perspective. And we're looking forward to have a lot of first-timers in Dallas, and you'd be a second-timer, and then you'd also, you know, make a comparative analysis to kind of also see exactly how BFU keeps on building and building and building. Okay. Okay, thank you.
So were you able to...